During the many years that I struggled with depression, I was searching for something to keep me afloat. It just didn't make sense that others could find beauty and magic in the world, while all of my thoughts and feelings seemed to be locked inside a painfully grey room. I couldn't remember what it felt like to be happy. There was no light for me to hold on to, which could lead me out of this gloomy despair. In 1974, I was blessed to be given a recording of Baba Ram Dass speaking at the Menninger Foundation in Topeka, Kansas. It was soon after he returned from his spiritual quest in India. Ram Dass, formerly known as Richard Alpert, had been a professor in psychology at Harvard University. He too had set out on a journey, searching for happiness. What he said gave me a glimmer of hope of there being an antidote for my misery. I remember him saying that the whole universe, in all its apparent diversity, was really just one vast ocean of energy, and that this energy was pure love. He said, "Even this chair is love." Well, that didn't make any sense to me, but somehow I really enjoyed hearing those words. Ram Dass's voice radiated an infectious joy. I sensed that he had come into contact with some higher teachings not available in the libraries of our universities. He told the audience how his teacher at the ashram instructed him by writing with chalk on a slate because he had taken a vow of silence for the last 10 years or so. One of the things he wrote was, "If you wear shoes, the whole world is covered with leather." This one sentence made a lasting impression upon me. Years later, it was joined by another image which says, "If you wear yellow-tinted glasses, everything in the world will be yellow." In other words, it was my beliefs, attitudes and thoughts which determined my mood every minute of the day. Soon after Ram Dass, I was influenced by the writings of the Sufis, the mystical order of Islam. Many of their teachings use images from nature which resonate within us beyond the limits of language. For example, the simple observation that the stars shine brightest on the darkest of nights almost immediately suggests a hidden gift waiting inside our despair. There is an allied saying which can be of great comfort to those with depression or grief. It says, "The darkest part of the night comes just before the new dawn." In other words, there is a point to it all. We haven't just stumbled off a cliff into a dark abyss from which there is no escape. Within my own inner darkness, I began to get a sense of possibility that this gloomy, forbidding melancholy was in fact the forerunner of something grand.